Swap partition was a necessity of any Linux installation in the past. Nowadays, more and more Linux distributions switch to a swap file instead of a swap partition. From this video, you will learn how to create and enable a swap file on your Linux system. Hello everyone, it's Ash Linux user helping you to install, configure and use Linux. You probably know that your Linux system uses RAM to store temporary files while the system is working. It may happen that all the RAM is used and there is no space to write temporary files. In this case, the Linux system tries to write these files into a swap. In the past, swap was a separate partition on your hard drive. But the problem was that it was very difficult to change its size. And that's why users usually created very large swap partitions. But a swap file can easily be changed. Nowadays, with increased amount of RAM, some systems don't use swap at all, so there is no need to allocate a lot of space for your swap. You can create a small swap file, and if needed in future you can increase its size. This is especially useful if you have a small SSD drive. But I have to say that swap partitions are still more reliable than swap files. That is why swap partitions are used on the server. But for a home computer, the flexibility of a swap file is preferable. You probably know that even Ubuntu have switched from swap partition to a swap file. So let's have a look how to create and enable a swap file on your Linux system. I will be showing all the process on Arch Linux installation. If you followed my previous video, you probably have seen that I installed Arch Linux without a swap. But this process is universal, so it will work on any other Linux distribution. So first we need to check if we have a swap available on our system. So you type swapon and then show. As you can see, it shows nothing because I have no swap on my system. You can also type free h to show the memory, and you can see that swap shows zero. So I have no swap on this system. Now let's create a swap file. Type sudo fallocate, and with option L you can specify the size of your swap. I will make a swap file of 1 gig, and I will place it into root. So now if we go to the root, if we type ls, you can see here's our swap file. So we have created a swap file. Fallocate should work for most of the cases. However, if your file system is f2fs or xfs, you should use dd command instead. So let me show you just for demonstration purposes how you do it. You type sudo dd and then you write zeros to the swap file. And you specify the file size in the option count in megabytes. So, but I'm not gonna do it, so I press Ctrl C to cancel it. Now we need to change the permission of our swap file and format it to swap. So as you can see, the file is formatted and now we need to activate it. So the file is activated. Now let's check again if we have a swap. So as you can see, our swap is active now and its size of 1 gig here. The last step, we need to add our swap file to fstab file so that it is loaded every time we boot into our system. So let's clean this, open the fstab file with nano, and in the end of the file, add your swap file by typing the following. Then press Ctrl O to save, then press Enter, and press Ctrl X to exit. Now reboot the system and check if your swap is active. As you can see, our swap is active after reboot. So now, for example, you decided to change the size of your swap file. Let me show you how to do it. So first switch off the swap and remove the swap file. Now do the same steps we done before, but with a different file size. Create a new swap file. Let's make it 512 megabytes. Make sure it has the correct permission. Format it as a swap. And activate the swap. You don't need to add swap file to fstab file because we didn't remove it from the fstab. So you can check that it's still present in the fstab file. After the reboot, your swap still will be active. So let's reboot now. And check the size of our swap. As you can see here, now the size of our swap has changed. And we can also see that swap is active when we check the RAM usage of our system. Now you can create a swap file and change its size anytime you need. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.